It prepares the stream, though it says it is Facebook Live. It is still setting up the Facebook. So just half a second more, half a minute more. Yeah, I think we should be good. It prepares the stream, though it says it is Facebook Live. It is still setting up the Facebook. So just half a second more, half a minute more. Yeah, okay.
Okay. So a very warm welcome to you, sir. Now, I would again like to request President Mugha to give your presidential remarks and some insights on today's session.
Thank you so much. A very warm welcome, first of all, to the guest speaker of today, Rotarian Shailesh Mahode. Shailesh Mahode, sir. And warm greetings to Rotarians from all over Maharashtra who have joined this meeting. Our month leaders this month, Rotarian Kirti Tak, Rotarian Raj Talreja, and the program committee chair, Rotarian Hemant Marathe, take great efforts in presenting a variety of programs. And the proof is the 81 attendance that we are seeing right now already before the program has started. As a part of the presidential address, I would just quickly highlight a few nice things that are happening about our club of late as we are wrapping up the year. First and foremost, we have a project which is ongoing in Ganesh Gaon, in which our club has undertaken a task of building 3 classrooms with the Zilla Parishad at Ganesh Gaon. This is expected to increase the attendance of that school by a huge number. And it is expected, despite the pandemic, our literacy directors, Rotarian Sachin Bagad and Rotarian Nilesh Sonja, are taking extreme efforts to ensure that we stick to a timeline. We are expecting to complete the project in June. However, anybody who wishes to donate happily for this project may do so and contact me or either of our secretaries. No amount is small enough for this good cause. Among other things that I would like to specially mention are that we are doing excellently in the district as far as the Rotary Foundation is concerned. And a humble request to everyone to... Where is it? Okay. A humble request to everyone to please come forward and donate to the Rotary Foundation. Any amount starting from even $5, $10 is good enough. Every small bit is going to make a positive difference to somebody. And the Rotary Foundation is one of the best foundations because it has the minimum expense ratio. And we can, because we have a trust, we can let our members avail of the ATG benefit. Another great thing that is happening is off late, there was a symposium on Interact and New Generations. And the district chair, Rotarian Virendra Patrikar, specially contacted us because we are at the forefront in the number of Interact clubs, in the number of activities that those Interact clubs are doing. And it is all a huge credit to the entire team Interact, which comprises of about 30 members. I cannot take the names here, but today's month leader, Rotarian Kirti Tak, Rotarian is one of them. And Rotarians Urmi Dinani and Rotarian Aditi Agrawal are the leaders, they're the directors. So heartiest congratulations to all of them. Today's topic, cryptocurrency, is, I think the minute people are seeing it, they said, we would like to attend this topic. There is so much in the papers about this. I remember a few years back, my daughter had said that she'd invested in Bitcoin and then had made some money on it. But then later on, it just, she sold out. And then after that, didn't enter it again. So I'm sure all of us have heard this term and are hearing this term. Is it legal? Is it not legal? Is Bitcoin the only cryptocurrency? What is it made? Where does it come from? And there are words used with it like mining. So what does it all mean really? I'm sure all of us have a whole lot of questions. And I'm told that today's speaker, and I'm sure, and I've heard a lot about it, that presents this topic excellently, very lucidly. And I will not take much time. I will hand over the stage to you, sir, for your talk. Please go ahead. But before that, I said, I think we need an informal introduction. So back to you, Kirti.
Hello. हाँ, तो सर जी का इंट्रोडक्शन का जिम्मा मेरे पे है। मैं रोटियन राज सलरेजा, शुभ संध्या रोटियन। ईश्वर ने भी कीमती रत्न गिनती के ही बनाए हैं। उन रत्नों में सबसे कीमती रत्न आप हमारे बीच में आए हैं, श्री शैलेश जी माड़ोदे। आज का टॉपिक है जो हमारा क्रिप्टो करेंसी। मार्केट का जो सीनेरियो चल रहा है उसमें इकोनॉमी का क्या सीन रहने वाला है वो मालूम नहीं है, तो हर कोई कुछ न कुछ नया एवेन्यू देखने की कोशिश कर रहा है। क्रिप्टो करेंसी का तो बहुत लोगों ने बहुत सुना हुआ है, लेकिन उसके बारे में हमको डेप्थ कुछ मालूम नहीं है। तो उसकी वजह से आज हमारा ये रोटरी के प्लेटफॉर्म पे हमने ये प्रोग्राम अरेंज करने सर ने बोला है, वैसे किया है। और उसका सर का जो इंट्रोडक्शन है उसका जिम्मा मेरे पे है। सर का नाम शैलेश माड़ोदे है, बाय प्रोफेशन साइंस राइटर एंड हेड ऑफ द ऑल इंडिया रेडियो नासिक। उनका एजुकेशन MSc मैथ्स, MA हिस्ट्री, MJ जर्नलिज्म, PG JMC। उनके लैंग्वेजेस जो उन्होंने अपने हासिल किए हैं उसमें माहिर, इंग्लिश, मराठी और हिंदी। उनका प्रोफेशनल एक्सपीरियंस है करियर स्पेनिंग मोर देन 2 decades इन साइंस जर्नलिज्म एंड ब्रॉडकास्टिंग एज अ प्रोफेशनल राइटर एंड क्रिएटिव प्रोड्यूसर इन लीडरशिप रोल। उनका रेडियो मीडिया कैरियर के बारे में उनका मैनेजमेंट एक्सपीरियंस, वर्क एज अ ARI स्टेशन स्टार्टिंग विथ ARI मुंबई, दिस इंक्लूड्स ARI सतारा, रत्नागिरी एंड नासिक। प्रेजेंटली हेडिंग ARI नासिक इन सेकेंड टेन्योर एट द स्टेशन एज इन अ प्रीवियस वन। उन्होंने काफी नोबेल लेक्चरर्स के उन्होंने इंटरव्यू लिए है, करीबन 25 विजिटिंग साइंटिस्ट ड्यूरिंग द कैरियर। काफी उनमें काफी बड़े बड़े लोगों के नाम है, गाडगिल साहब है, शर्मा जी है। वर्किंग एज अ कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटिंग प्रोड्यूसर एंड अ नेशनल कॉरेस्पॉन्डेंट फॉर रेडियोस्कोप साइंस मैगजीन। कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटेड 300 न्यू न्यूज कॉमेंट्रीज ऑन साइंस फॉर FM गोल्ड चैनल एंड कवर्ड 52 विजिट्स ऑफ प्राइम मिनिस्टर एंड प्रेसिडेंट एंड प्रोड्यूसर रेडियो रिपोर्ट्स। उनकी खासियत यह है कि उन्होंने जब कुंभ मेला हुआ था लेट, उन्होंने तभी पूरा कम कुंभ मेला जो है 2003 का, उसमें वो उनका खास उनका स्पेशल ड्यूटी था और उन्होंने वो पूरा ब्रॉडकास्ट किया था रेडियो के ऊपर। फैकल्टी ऑफ अ रेडियो जर्नलिज्म ऑफ अ मास्टर स्टूडेंट ऑफ नामदास जी के गोखले स्कूल जर्नलिज्म एंड मास कम्युनिकेशन HPT कॉलेज नासिक सिंस 2013 एंड ऑल्सो टॉट रेडियो जर्नलिज्म कोर्स इन इंग्लिश एट जेवियर्स कॉलेज मुंबई एंड साइंस फॉर रेडियो कोर्स नेशनल सेंटर फॉर साइंस मुंबई। कंडक्टेड मैनी इन हाउस ट्रेनिंग वानी ट्रेनिंग वर्कशॉप एज अ प्रोग्राम हेड टू द ट्रेन रेडियो जॉकीज। प्रेजेंटली वर्किंग ऑन द कमिटी कंसल्टेड ऑन द फॉर द कंटेंट एंड कोर्स ऑफ यशवंतराव चव्हाण महाराष्ट्र ओपन यूनिवर्सिटी। ऑल्सो इन्वॉल्व इन द कोर्स मटेरियल डेवलपमेंट एज अ ऑथर एंड एडिटर। उनको जो अवार्ड्स मिले हैं उसमें से जो सबसे जो बड़े हैं इसमें दिए हैं आरोग्य ज्ञानेश्वर अवार्ड इन 2006 फॉर सब्सटेंशियल कंट्रीब्यूशन इन द फील्ड ऑफ हेल्थ जर्नलिज्म थ्रू ARI। नेशनल मीडिया अवार्ड 2009, वांगमाया पुरस्कार स्टेट लिटरेसी अवार्ड ऑफ गवर्नमेंट ऑफ महाराष्ट्र, वीर सावरकर अवार्ड बाय फुले जिला in 2010 for best popular science book of Ati Sukhamaya Mahapravachanda, an executive book on nanotechnology. Life member of National Center for Science Communicators, Mumbai since inception in 1999. He was involved in organizing annual conference of the centers. Member of Academic Council of YCMU Nasik since March 2019. Sir, the dais is yours now.
Sir, you're muted, sir. Sir, unmute karay lagel tumhala.
Sorry. Thanks for the nice introduction. Actually, I'm trying my bit to demystify science and talk and deliver something credible. which people can use in their day-to-day life. And that is what is very important for me. And particularly these new emerging technological issues, which are concerned with finance, is now a special topic of my interest these days. And that's how I am initiated into this currency, cryptocurrency thing. With the help of Dr. Vinayak Govilkar, I developed special interest in economics, and as such, mathematics and economics goes together these days. Particularly, we can see that all these data science, which we are saying, all this, the economy, the so-called data economy, which we are experiencing and which is unfolding. And now there are talks of digital e-coins also issued by government, means the central bank, that is Reserve Bank of India in case of India. This cryptocurrency has generated huge interest since it was first introduced. The Bitcoin is the term which most of us are familiar with, but this particular term was not in existence till 2008, when there are cyber funks, the people who are interested in doing something which is out of intellectual world only, not necessarily it is useful for solving some problem in our day-to-day life. So it's a cryptography thing. For the nerds who are in the IT field, they are aware of what cryptography is. Here, most of us are not really very concerned about the technological issues, but we are more concerned with finance and the policy issue and how we in this country are going to deal with the challenge or the regulations regarding the cryptocurrency that we are going to see. The Bitcoin was introduced by a pseudo person, maybe a group of persons. His name was Nakamoto, Satoshi Nakamoto. I'm using his because I consider one person. Maybe he was a group of persons, perhaps. He started this particular movement and then disappeared. Nobody knows, nobody has any clue who that fellow is, who has introduced this Bitcoin and set a limit of 21 million Bitcoins will be issued. And that will be till 22nd century. He was interested in most of the kind of thing where central banking regulation should not be there, as some sort of people are there who believe in anarchy and some regulation which we can deal with people peer to peer without having anything in between. Now what we have to do is digital payments, which we are doing, but there is a payment gateway and we have to go through various banks as an institution, or maybe central bank if you want to transfer some money to other country in their currency and all those things. So all these issues are there and they are being dealt as money and economy is a thing where all the time we can have new innovations coming up. So this cryptocurrency has brought a new interest again in the money supply and cutting down so-called middlemen. And this is how it actually started in 2008. Now in India, we have officially no cryptocurrency which is granted a status of an official currency. But cryptocurrency in the first place was not started for having something official recognition. It was other way around. So when we are talking about various cryptocurrencies, there are thousands of them which are available, virtual money, digital money we can call simply for this cryptocurrency, and all the currencies which every nation issues in the name of their central bank, whatever they call Fed Reserve in US, Bank of England in England, and like that. So we have Reserve Bank of India, where we have all these paper money issued by them, or the digital transactions which we go through with various digital wallets. These e-wallets is regulated by Reserve Bank. But in cryptocurrency case, since I have already told you, there is a limit has been kept for number of Bitcoins. We are talking about Bitcoins. There are many other e-coins, cryptocurrencies that are there. We will deal with it subsequently. But Bitcoin, when the first Bitcoin was mined and issued, it was just 6 cents. One Bitcoin for 6 cents. That is how it started. In 2010, when there was a exchange was registered in on net, that time it was 9 cents. Then in February, we saw how much it was. It has stopped because that time Tesla, Elon Musk has said that we will deal with Bitcoins and they will accept payment in Bitcoins. PayPal was already accepting it. So we really are talking about a very big money, and people are talking about it in a different way, differently. Lots of confusion is there. Some say it is digital assets. Some say it is currency. Some say it is just peer-to-peer trade simplification, whatever. So first we have to understand that this presently, since 2018, when Reserve Bank banned the trading in cryptocurrency, this is not an officially recognized thing for anybody in India. But we have a cryptocurrency exchange called WazirX in Mumbai, which is the largest cryptocurrency exchange in India, which deals with transactions to the tune of 171 crores a day. Recently in Dog eCoins, it had even more amount involved in transactions. There are issues like who can mine the currency, how that currency operates. Many, many things are there. Let me tell you in the first place that cryptocurrency actually rests on a technology called blockchain. In blockchain technology, what happens is that it's a public ledger, actually. It is available on the net for everybody who has been given access to or has the key to log in and check the details. Any transaction which we do in economy, that has to be verified by the third party so that it has a sanctity. But we are here in India or everywhere in the world, the trust is a factor which requires some sort of efforts for us to have in. In America, a survey was conducted for having the trust factor verified. And last, about 15 things, institutions were very verified. And UN, the trust of people in the US Congress was last 15. And just before that were the businesses. So when the world of businesses is there, the trust factor is important. That's why the peer-to-peer dealing is going to be very, very essential. Having said that, there are many things which we can discuss about this cryptocurrency. 2019 मध्ये Libra नावाचं करन्सी फेसबुकने इश्यू करायचं ठरवलं आणि त्यानंतर बऱ्याच गोष्टी मध्ये लोकांचा इंटरेस्ट निर्माण झाला की बिटकॉइन्स च्या पाठोपाठ जर फेसबुकनी ज्याचं नेटवर्क ट्रान्स वर्ल्ड आहे पूर्ण जगामध्ये कुठेही कशाही प्रकारे जर त्यांनी त्यांचे नेटवर्क केलं आणि त्याच्यातून करन्सी इश्यू केल्या तर मग त्याचं रेग्युलेशन कोण कसं कशा प्रकारे करेल. आणि दॅट वॉज अ टर्निंग पॉईंट फॉर ऑल द सेंट्रल बँक्स इन द वर्ल्ड टू अवेक. अँड नाऊ देर इज अ टॉक ऑफ इश्युईंग देअर ओन डिजिटल कॉइन्स. फॉर दॅट द कंपनी देअर बँक्स हॅव सेटअप or taken various measures. They have set up some committees for study and something. There is one country in this world at this moment which has issued central bank issued e-coins, that is Bahamas. Singapore is in the process, and Estonia is a country where most of the digital infrastructure is stronger, and so they are talking in terms of that.
Sir, sorry to interrupt, ithe tech chat box madhe request yete hai ki please talk in Hindi or Marathi also, so maybe you can intersperse a little.
Okay, मी आता मराठीत बोलतोय, हिंदीत पण असं मध्ये थोडं थोडं बोलेन. तो आता क्रिप्टोकरन्सीच्या संदर्भामध्ये जर जेव्हा बोलायचं तर आपल्या भारतामध्ये मी जसं म्हणालो की 2018 मध्ये त्याच्यावरती ऑफिशियली बॅन आहे, तरी सुद्धा ट्रेडिंग होत आहे. कारण हे बेसिकली क्रिप्टोकरन्सीच्या बाबतीमध्ये सध्या आपण त्याच्याकडे एक ऍसेट क्लास म्हणून बघतो आहोत, आणि क्रिप्टोकरन्सीचे जे एक्सचेंजेस आहेत त्यांच्या वजीरेक्सच्या सीईओने मला सांगितलं होतं, निश्चल शेट्टी म्हणून आहे त्यांनी, की नाऊ वी आर गोईंग फॉर रेग्युलेशन, म्हणजे आम्हाला रेग्युलेशन अपेक्षित आहे. आणि म्हणूनच गव्हर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडियाने जेव्हा एक बिल इंट्रोड्यूस केलं पार्लमेंटमध्ये करण्याचं ठरवलेलं आहे, तेव्हा त्याचं सुरुवातीला नॉमेनक्लेचर होतं बॅनिंग, ते बदललं त्यांनी, आणि आता त्याचं इश्युअन्स ऑफ रेग्युलर रेग्युलेशन वगैरे साठीचं त्यांनी ते बिल पार्लमेंटमध्ये आणायचं ठरवलं होतं. गेल्याच हिवाळी अधिवेशनामध्ये ते बिल मांडण्यात येणार होतं, पण मी जसं म्हणालो की सध्या याबद्दलची एक्सपर्टाईज जशी बँक ऑफ इंग्लंडकडे कमी आहे, जशी फेड रिझर्व्हकडे कमी आहे, तशीच रिझर्व्ह बँकेकडे पण कमी आहे, भारतीय गव्हर्नमेंट सिस्टम मध्ये पण ती कमी आहे. सुभाष गर्ग फॉर्मर एक फायनान्स सेक्रेटरी होते, त्यांच्या अध्यक्षतेखाली एक कमिटी बनवली होती, त्यांनी काही गोष्टी सुचवलेल्या आहेत. पण मुळातच या संदर्भामध्ये जोपर्यंत आपण ही टेक्नॉलॉजी समजून घेत नाही तोपर्यंत या संदर्भात बऱ्याच गोष्टी महत्वाच्या आहेत. आता याच्यात सोप्या भाषेत सांगायचं झालं तर ब्लॉक चेन टेक्नॉलॉजीचा मी उल्लेख केला, ब्लॉक चेन टेक्नॉलॉजी फक्त क्रिप्टोकरन्सीसाठी उपयुक्त ठरणार नसून अनेक वेगवेगळ्या गोष्टींसाठी उपयुक्त ठरणार आहे. तर ती टेक्नॉलॉजी तशी जुनीच आहे खरं तर. आता आपण क्रिप्टोकरन्सी ऑपरेट कशी होते याच्याविषयी या ब्लॉक चेन वरती त्याचा थोडासा विचार करू. ब्लॉक चेन का जो नेटवर्क है ना उसके ऊपर, जैसे अगर मैं एक यूजर हूं और मेरे पास ब्लॉकचेन में या एंटर करने के लिए कुछ ट्रेडिंग करने के लिए की है, वो जो की है वो की सिर्फ आपको मालूम होनी चाहिए, क्योंकि यहाँ कोई थर्ड पार्टी नहीं है, लास्ट कोई आकर बचाने वाला नहीं है यहाँ बैंक में आपको. यहाँ का सब कुछ जो कुछ भी होगा वो ट्रांसपेरेंसी की बात हो रही है, तो ट्रांसपेरेंसी में पूरा पब्लिकली अवेलेबल डेटा रहेगा. कोई भी 2008 से बिटकॉइन का ट्रांजेक्शन चालू हुआ उसके बाद से लेकर आज तक जितने ट्रांजेक्शन पीयर टू पीयर हुए हैं वो सभी उस पर रिकॉर्डेड है, और जिसके पास उस पे ब्लॉकचेन बिटकॉइन के ब्लॉकचेन पे लॉगिन करने जिसके पास की है जो कि फिजिकल फॉर्म में रहता है, वो एंटर करने के बाद आपको हर ट्रांजेक्शन चेक करने को मिलेगा. क्योंकि सीधी सी बात है, अगर आपके पास 10 रुपए है और आपने वो 10 रुपए कोई दूसरा आदमी तो यूज नहीं करेगा ना, जब आपने खरीद लिया तो दूसरे को पैसे दे दिए. बिटकॉइन के ऊपर ये पैसे कैसे चेक करेंगे कि आपने जो बिटकॉइन खरीदा है और उसके ऊपर ट्रांजेक्शन किया है, तो उसके लिए वो ट्रांजेक्शन पूरे नेटवर्क पे ब्लॉकचेन के नेटवर्क पे घंटे में 6 बार अपडेट होता है. एवरी 10 मिनट्स इट इज अपडेटेड, एंड इन दैट 10 मिनट्स द पर्सन हु इज इन ए पोजिशन टू सॉल्व ए पर्टिकुलर एल्गोरिदम जो कि डिफिकल्ट होता है लेकिन वो सॉल्व होने के बाद में समझने के लिए बहुत आसान होता है, तो वो जो सॉल्व करेगा उसको ये पूरा माइनिंग का कमीशन मिलेगा। जो माइनर्स है उसको इस चीज का कमीशन मिलता है। लेकिन ये कमीशन कैसे मिलता है, वहां तो कोई एक अथॉरिटी है नहीं, पूरा जो कुछ ब्लॉकचेन है वो पूरा पूरा डाइवर्सिफाइड वर्चुअली है पूरी जगह, जैसे पहले शुरुआत में इंटरनेट की बात होती थी, आणि इंटरनेट वरती कुठलीही गोष्ट मोकळी आहे तर त्याचा अर्थ असा आहे की इट्स अ पब्लिक प्रॉपर्टी, म्हणजे सगळेजण आपण त्याचे ओनर आहोत, आपण ओनर आहोत म्हणजे कोणीच ओनर नाही। दिस इज अ फॅक्ट, इफ इट इज ओन बाय एव्हरीबडी देन नोबडी ओन्स इट। त्यामुळे रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी याची सेफ्टीची ही त्या इंडिव्हिज्युअल व्यक्तीवरती येते, आणि हेच ब्लॉक चेन्स आहे। म्हणजे एकदा एक ट्रान्झॅक्शन तुम्ही केलं त्या ब्लॉक चेन वरती तर ते ट्रान्झॅक्शन अपलोड होतं आणि 10 मिनिटांमध्ये असे 6 वेळा ते अपलोड होतं, अगदी काही सेकंदांमध्ये, आणि त्या दरम्यानच्या काळामध्ये ते सगळे ट्रान्झॅक्शन 2008 पासून झालेले प्रत्येक व्यक्तीकडे जो त्या बिटकॉइनच्या ब्लॉक चेन वर आहे त्याच्याकडे पण ते अपडेट होतात। म्हणजे इट्स ए ओपन पब्लिक लेजर, आणि हीच लेजर सिस्टम आता बिटकॉइनच्या संदर्भात चालू आहे। आणि म्हणूनच जेव्हा एलॉन मस्क हॅज सेड नाउ दॅट ही विल नॉट ऍक्सेप्ट बिटकॉइन फॉर टेस्ला, तर तेव्हा आपल्याला प्रश्न पडतो की 1 महिना 2 महिन्यापूर्वी ज्या माणसाने टेस्ला साठी बिटकॉइन स्वीकारणार असं म्हटलं होतं ना, आता का नाही? कारण परत तेच बिझनेस आणि त्याची प्राइस, स्पेक्युलेटर्स सध्या या झोन मध्ये जास्त पुढे आहेत, पैसे स्पेक्युलेट करून काही लोकांना खूप फायदा झाला। जसं मी म्हणालो की बिटकॉइन सुरुवातीला फक्त 6 सेंटला होतं, आता तर लक्षावधी रुपयांमध्ये ते बिटकॉइन डॉलर्समध्ये त्याची किंमत आहे। तर बिटकॉइन हे फक्त क्रिप्टो करन्सी झालं, तसेच इथेरियम आणि असे हजारो डॉगी कॉइन्स असो, लाईट कॉइन असो, वेगवेगळ्या प्रकारचे हजारो पर्याय सध्या उपलब्ध आहे। त्याचा जर आपण विचार करायचा झाला तर आपल्याला लक्षात घ्यावं लागेल की जे वेगवेगळे पर्याय आहेत ते वेगवेगळे पर्याय या वेगवेगळ्या प्लॅटफॉर्म्स वरती आपल्याला उपलब्ध आहेत। क्रिप्टो करन्सीज म्हटल्यानंतर झेड कॅश, मोनेरो, डॅश हे क्रिप्टो करन्सीज मध्ये येतात। याच्यानंतर एक दुसरा ऑप्शन आहे तो प्रोटोकॉल टोकन्सचा, त्याच्यामध्ये इथेरियमचा उल्लेख हल्ली खूप होतोय, ते इथेरियम त्याच्यामध्ये येतात। त्यानंतर आयसीकॉन, आयसीऑन, आयऑन, कॉस्मॉस, नियो आहेत, युटिलिटी टोकन्स आहेत, सिक्युरिटी टोकन्स आहेत, नॅचरल असेट्स आहेत, त्याच्यानंतर क्रिप्टो कलेक्टिबल्स आहेत, क्रिप्टो फियाट करन्सीज आहेत, आणि 2025 मध्ये डॉलरच्या संदर्भात पण ई डॉलर सारखं काहीतरी क्रिप्टो करन्सीच्या स्वरूपात पेडी इश्यू करणार आहे, त्याच्याविषयीची चर्चा आहे। आणि चायनानी या संदर्भामध्ये ऑलरेडी 1 लाख लोकांना त्यांच्या तर्फे दिलेल्या क्रिप्टो करन्सीचा एक्सपेरिमेंटच्या दृष्टीने इश्यू केलेले आहे, तर त्या संदर्भात पण चर्चा सध्या मोठ्या प्रमाणावर सुरू आहे। ब्लॅक ब्लॉक चेन टेक्नॉलॉजी मध्ये काय होतं की एका ब्लॉक वरती एक ट्रान्झॅक्शन कम्प्लीट झालं तर त्याची अशी चेन पूर्ण सलग लागते, आणि तेच मी म्हणालो की पब्लिक लेजर मध्ये प्रत्येकाला ते तपासून बघता येऊ शकत। म्हणून त्याची किंमत जेव्हा आपण करतो एखादं ट्रान्झॅक्शन अप्रूव एक्सचेंज वरती या क्रिप्टो करन्सीच्या, तेव्हा ऍक्च्युली त्या ठिकाणी 2 व्यक्ती 2 पीयर्स मध्ये तो व्यवहार झालेला असतो, आणि त्याच्यातून ते एकमेकांना बिटकॉइनच्या स्वरूपात पैसे देतात त्यावेळेला बिटकॉइनची जी प्राइस असेल त्या प्राइस मध्ये। हे झालं क्रिप्टो करन्सीच्या संदर्भात जनरल इन्फॉर्मेशन, म्हणजे काय नेमकं आहे याच्या संदर्भात। आता भारताच्या संदर्भामध्ये आपण जरा विचार करायचं ठरवलं तर मी सांगितलं आहेच की 2018 मध्ये रिझर्व्ह बँकेने याच्या संदर्भात कुठल्याही प्रकारचे ट्रान्झॅक्शन करण्याला बंदी घातली होती। नंतर त्याच्यावरती कोर्ट केस झाली, त्या कोर्ट केसमध्ये रिझर्व्ह बँकेने म्हणजे सुप्रीम कोर्टाने डिसिजन असा दिला की कुठल्याही बँका पब्लिक सेक्टरमधल्या विशेष करून आणि नंतर आता तर प्रायव्हेट सेक्टरमधले देखील ते याला सपोर्ट करणार नाहीत. त्यामुळे जेव्हा तुम्ही या संदर्भातले ट्रान्झॅक्शन कराल तेव्हा या ट्रान्झॅक्शनच्या संदर्भामध्ये तुम्हाला तो रिस्क फॅक्टर लक्षात घेऊनच तो करावा लागतो. सध्या तरी म्हणजे फक्त आपल्याकडे पैसे आहेत म्हणून आपण इन्व्हेस्ट करायचे आणि ह्याची किंमत सतत वाढत राहील अशी आशा करायची, तर शेअर मार्केटच्या संदर्भातलं जे काही प्रिन्सिपल आपण लक्षात घेतलं पाहिजे, जोपर्यंत किंमत वाढते तोपर्यंत वाढते. ज्या वेळेला शेअर मार्केटमधला पूर्ण तुमच्याकडून ती गोष्ट खरेदी करायला कोणीही बायर नसतो तेव्हा त्याची व्हॅल्यू झिरो होते. तसाच प्रकार याही बाबतीत घडू शकतो. आतापर्यंत घडलेला नाही, परंतु जर
सर योर वॉइस इज फ्रोजन आई थिंक. Sir?
Video is also blocked.
Yeah, video is also blocked. Rajbhai, can you please call him and also tell him that he can stick to Hindi and English, because I think khup log have joined and they're requesting Hindi. So maybe Hindi, English, Marathi combination might be better.
तो हम बात कर रहे थे कि ये जो क्रिप्टो करेंसी की बात है उसमें हम यह कोशिश करेंगे ज्यादा से ज्यादा समझने की कि भारत में इसकी क्या स्थिति होगी. अभी तो यह है कि भारत में ये ऑफिशियली अलाउड नहीं है. क्रिप्टो करेंसी में आप ट्रेडिंग कर सकते हैं, कई लोगों ने इसमें पैसे इन्वेस्ट भी किए हैं और लोग चाहते हैं तो उसमें वो पैसे बना भी सकते हैं, गंवा भी सकते हैं. तो ये खुला मार्केट है. चूंकि इसमें आप पैसे जब गंवाएंगे तो आप अपील कहां करेंगे, तो फिलहाल तो ऐसी कोई इसमें चीज है नहीं जहां पर आप अपील सके. और जब गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया मतलब रिजर्व बैंक अपने खुद के ई कॉइन इशू, हम इसके बारे में अलग से सोचेंगे, क्योंकि इंटरनेट पर कोई भी ट्रांजैक्शन जब हम करते हैं तो हमें फिलहाल जो डेटा जनरेट होता है वो डेटा एक स्पेसिफिक डेटा सेंटर में स्टोर होते हुए दिखता है, जबकि यहाँ पर ऐसा कोई डेटा सेंटर नहीं होगा. इट इज ऑल स्कैटर्ड इन ब्लॉक्स एंड ब्लॉकचेन्स ऑल ओवर द वर्चुअल वर्ल्ड ऑफ इंटरनेट. रिजर्व बैंक इसके बारे में अभी शक्तिकांता दास जो गवर्नर है उन्होंने कहा था कि हम इसके बारे में डिजिटल कॉइन इशू करेंगे, लेकिन मैं आपको ये बता दूं कि अभी फिलहाल बहुत सारे जगह पर इस बारे में चर्चा चालू है, कमिटीज बनाई गई हैं इसके बारे में. दूसरे देशों का भी अनुभव अभी कोई खास अच्छा नहीं रहा है ई कॉइन्स के बारे में, और कुल मिलाकर ई कॉइन्स का इशू करने का मतलब ये हुआ है, आपको ध्यान में लेना होगा कि जो मनी हम सेविंग करते हैं या जमा करते हैं और बैंक में रखते हैं, वो बैंक बाद में वो पैसे लोन देकर इंटरेस्ट कमाता है, मतलब मनी जनरेट करता है. ये चीज उसमें नहीं होगी, क्योंकि हम सीधा पैसा सेंट्रल बैंक के पास जमा करेंगे, वहां इस तरह का कोई सिस्टम नहीं होगा. इसलिए पब्लिक सेक्टर बैंक या फिर कोई भी प्राइवेट बैंक का ही वजूद ही इसके बारे में सोचना बहुत आवश्यक होगा, क्योंकि देयर विल बी नो लोन्स. लोन्स के लिए पैसा नहीं होगा, लोग पैसा नहीं देंगे उसके अंदर, तो लोन कहां से होगा, फिर बैंक का अस्तित्व क्या, ये सब चीजें और आगे आने वाली है, इसके बारे में सोच विचार चालू है. लेकिन जो एनार्किस्ट टाइप के लोग हैं जो नई नई आइडियाज के बारे में सोचते हैं, जो चाहते हैं कि इंस्टीट्यूशंस का कॉन्फिडेंस लेवल बहुत कम है, सो लेट्स हैव अ सिस्टम वेर इन एवरीबडी विल नो एवरी ट्रांजैक्शन, सो इट विल ब्रिंग मोर ट्रांसपेरेंसी. दिस इज अ फिलोसॉफिकल थिंग इज वन थिंग, बट व्हेन एक्चुअल लाइफ एंड फाइनेंस एंड सिस्टम कम्स देन वी हैव टू थिंक अबाउट many issues which are very important from the people's point of view. और इसके बारे में अभी हमें सोचना होगा. हेलो
यस सर, आप कंटिन्यू कीजिए सर जी, कंटिन्यू कीजिए।
तो हम क्रिप्टोकरेंसी के बारे में जब सोचते हैं एंड वी आर थिंकिंग इसका कलर ये होगा, किस रंग के नोट होंगे, तो ऐसा कुछ नहीं है। बिटकॉइन भी एक्चुअली आपको कोई कॉइन नहीं मिलता, सिर्फ एक लेजर में आपका नाम का एंट्री होता है जहां पर आपके ट्रांजैक्शन दर्ज होते हैं ब्लॉकचेन के ऊपर। बस आप कोई भी पैसा फिजिकली आपके हाथ में नहीं आएगा, आपका रहेगा लेकिन आपको यूज करने के लिए उसका की जरूर ध्यान में रखना पड़ेगा और वो की दोबारा इश्यू नहीं होता है। जिसके पास की उसका पैसा, ये चीज बिल्कुल साफ है। इसलिए क्रिप्टो करेंसी ये शब्द जो आया है वो एक्चुअली क्रिप्टोग्राफी, ये जो कंप्यूटर फील्ड का एक मेजर सेक्टर है जहां पर कोडिंग हायर लेवल के ऊपर होकर जिसका संबंध इकोनॉमिक ट्रांजैक्शन के साथ जोड़ने का कोशिश काफी हो रहा है। अभी पेपैल के बारे में मैंने कहा था कि पेपैल हैज मेनी यूजर्स, यहाँ पर ये क्रिप्टो करेंसी चलती है, बिटकॉइन वगैरह ईबे पे चलती है। देर आर मेनी मर्चेंडाइज, मोर देन 35,000 मर्चेंडाइज ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड आर एक्सेप्टिंग क्रिप्टो करेंसी। लेकिन इंडिया में अभी क्रिप्टो करेंसी किस ढंग से एक्सेप्ट हो रही है इसके बारे में क्लैरिटी बहुत कम है। देर आर फ्यू थिंग्स विच वी मस्ट कीप इन माइंड दैट वी एज ए इंडियन ऑलवेज गो फॉर सिक्योरिटी, वी वॉन्ट सम सॉर्ट ऑफ सिक्योरिटी, सम एश्योरेंस। दैट इज व्हाई द इंस्टीट्यूशनल सपोर्ट इज वेरी वेरी क्रूशियल इन दिस फील्ड एंड दिस इज वॉट इज putting us on defense. Though there are more than 7 lakh people who have invested in cryptocurrency in India, if the Reserve Bank or that bill, the parliament, if the bill is approved and there is no provision of regulation but they have blanketly banned this revolution, then they are at receiving end. They don't know, they have to be given some way to get out of it, because their wealth will totally wiped out in a moment. So all this, when you are talking about currency, so currency is a misnomer actually. They want to call it as a crypto assets. It is kind of a substitute for gold or something which can be easily liquefied in market, can be traded, and the value increases and goes down and comes up. Gold, we have only seen value going up relatively. But as far as the cryptocurrencies are concerned, value goes up. Some of them have gone out of the business altogether also. And this Nakamoto has set the limit of $21 billion, I have told you, dollars. That will be reached in 22nd century, next century maybe. And then there will be issues, because already their supply is less, so price is increasing. But when people dumped it, like Elon Musk or somebody, then the price goes down. February it was on a very upswing. One Bitcoin was costing more than 5 lakhs dollars. Now it is lesser. This is what we have to live with. But this cryptocurrency, we cannot predict at this moment where it will take us. But definitely the world of finance is on a cusp of a major revolution. There will be a major revolution international finance sector, because fintech area is going to revolutionize everything. We are talking about globalization, the same way the globalization of the money will be there, and there the nationalism, the currency. Currency is basically a nationalistic thing because it has the nationalistic flavor. Dollar which is a world's currency. Now, if the digital currency comes, what will happen with the dollar? Whether it will be retaining its position, that we don't know. That we it is to be still to be deliberated upon. Now there are talks, there are other geopolitical things, China's cryptocurrency will really happen or not, but there are steps which are in that direction. So we have to really be very, very cautious. At the same time, adventurous. Some of us are very adventurous, so we can go for this, but there is no legally sanctioned thing in this transactions at this moment. Even though there are cryptocurrency exchanges which are functioning in India, and that Wazir XI mentioned, it is the largest crypto exchange in India. But things really are going to go forward. Let us see. As we are turning more and more digital, virtual, our existence will be more of an internet entry, digital entry, than what we actually like to do a transaction and feel the handing over of some kind of means of exchange, what we call as currency. I think I have talked very broadly about many of these things, because there are few very, very technical issues which will take certain time and kind of things which may not be easily addressed in a function like this in a very limited amount of time. But definitely, if you have any questions, I will be very glad to answer now. Thanks.
Hello. Hello. Marode sir, there is one question from the audience.
Yes.
Mr. Vineet is asking, can you please explain cryptocurrency in more detail, in more fundamental way, as it is working in Africa, and how crypto will help in underdeveloped and developing countries and all?
That in Africa, M-Pesa, maybe he may be talking about that. M-Pesa, that kind of thing. And these are the issues. Then money laundering issue is there. That cryptocurrency has an issue related with some sort of, it is going in the hands of the people who are involved in terrorist activities. All these things I have not mentioned. This kind of things are actually operating in Africa also in this manner. Cryptocurrency, as I told you, since it is issued and mint by anybody, mined by anybody, and he has a key, then naturally it will operate into it. Of course, in Bahamas, I have given you, it is officially that their central bank has issued, because Bahamas is a geographically, if you see, it's a small islands. There are many silent islands which are scattered all over, and they have many communities to be taken care of, where the money cannot reach and the transactions cannot happen. For them, it is the Reserve Bank, their Reserve Bank, the Central Bank has taken the issue. For us here at this moment, when we are not in a position to fully reach digitally at many places, though the money has been transferred, but there are issues. Phone Pay is also there. All these things are there. But in cryptocurrency, as I told you, there will be no central authority. That is main important thing. It's a publicly open ledger. And that is what is cryptocurrency all about. That is its plus point, selling point, that nobody who wants some money, which is, or some asset, which is created at the internet, to be known to the public, but not known to the regulator. That is how the cryptocurrency functions.
Yes, sir. There is one more question. Can you please explain why cryptocurrency are banned in India? Hello?
Cryptocurrencies are banned in India because, as I told you, we are not fully conversant with its functioning. there is that layer. Blockchain technology is an emerging technology which is not fully mastered for all the purposes in our country. We don't have that sufficient manpower at the government level also to understand the real functioning of blockchains. And that is why that cryptocurrency initially was banned, because there will be no central authority, there will be no nation which will have that currency. Currency means nation. Particular currency is issued by nation. When you are talking about cryptocurrency, there is no nation in picture. So as India, our institution, central authority, they will definitely think about it, because it is ultimately the control which is important. Control over economy and fiscal transactions. Earlier, what has happened, you know, in somebody who knows economics very well, we can say that Reserve Bank has certain fund which is kept reserved there, but the all the bankers which operate, they operate on the savings or the money put by the customers, and on that basis they do the business and generate money, and that is how the money is created.
Okay. One question is from Jatin Jain. He is asking, which is the best app to trade in cryptocurrency? Which app?
that is what I am telling you. See, when the Wazir X was established, he also searched for many apps. There are, I have mentioned many of them, Ethereum and all these things. WazirX also has an app. I will not be able to tell you one app over other app. There are issues regarding that. It cannot be, I am not competent enough to grade the apps at this moment.
So another question is, when the currency is not supported by any government, why it should be invested in? When there are huge swings in the value, why investors should invest?
As I told you, it is for the speculators, those who want to make good money. Why we invest in share markets? To make money. Many of us, share market goes up, comes down, goes up, comes down. But there is a central authority who is controlling all these things. Maybe NSE or maybe CDSL or whatever. But in cryptocurrency, there is no central authority. As I told you, it is all a publicly open ledger system. So if you want to, as I clearly already pointed out, in India, it is not yet legal. If you want to make money still and have some way to make money and then use it also, it's better to invest. Otherwise, it is better to wait.
Yes. Rajbhai, next question, please.
You go ahead. You only ask, madam.
Sir, next question, sir. Do you think bubble of cryptos are going to burst like housing bubble? If yes, what economical issues it will cause?
We don't know. It is a bubble until it is burst. That is what is the basic problem with the economy. When it went burst, the Lehman Brothers lost everything in 2000, and then we realized that it was a bubble. Same thing, dot-com boom also we had. It goes on and on. As I told you, in the share market, the price goes on and on, and you price keep on increasing. So you keep on accumulating the things. And one fine day, if there is no buyers for your this thing, then you lose. That is how it works. That is why we have to wait for the things, because in finance field, there are always speculators who have made lots of money. Recently, we had seen one example of an investor, angel investor. He made billions of dollars and lost everything in one go. So this is how the finance field works, because for it works on the greed, and greed is always not bad. It is considered, but we know where to stop and where not to, and that is very difficult to tell where to stop.
on that thing only, one person has asked, what is the minimum amount one can invest in cryptocurrency?
Any number of amounts. If you can mine that much, but I have told you, upper limit of total number of bitcoins issued. Similarly, all currencies will have their certain limit or may not be having, because we don't know what is, we are talking Bitcoin because it is a popular currency, cryptocurrency all over the world. That's why. But there are many other. Doge coins is also there. The Tesla now disowned Bitcoins, and Elon Musk was talking about now because it consumes a lot of energy, all these cryptocurrency networks, because it's obvious. We could say virtual ledger which updates every 6 minutes, every 10 minutes, six times a day, hour. You can imagine how much energy is required for that network to function. That is why it is sometimes said that it is environmentally not wasteful.
So, can I take the next question?
Yes.
Yes. If the cryptocurrency transaction information is available in public domain, how can we see it?
You have to invest and have a key for it. Then you can see it, every transaction, right from the inception, as far as Bitcoin is concerned. For other, there are different mechanisms. That is what is the issue. We have a lot of cement companies, this, that, similarly. But currency, we have only one nationwide. But if we are going to have this kind of cryptocurrency thing, then we are in for a major disruption around the corner in the field of finance, maybe in next 3-4 years.
Shailesh, I want to ask.
Yes.
Hello.
Yes.
I want to ask that if officially in India, cryptocurrency is not legal, then how come exchanges like WazirX are allowed to function?
See,
which basically deal in cryptocurrencies.
They deal in cryptocurrencies because they are just the trading sets. They are not doing any transaction. They are just providing the platform.
No,
in peer-to-peer transactions.
In legal parlance, when we say aiding and abetting, by launching official exchanges, isn't it tantamount to saying that yes, you are aiding and abetting the illegal?
Yes, but the Supreme Court delivered the judgment exactly in a different manner in 2018. That is what I am telling you. It has left out this current exchanges untouched, but put the onus on the banks not to cooperate or invest. Now they are operating, but none of the banks which can be mediary in between the transactions or the money which you will invest. And without bank authorization, all the transaction which we do in India without RBI interface are, of course, illegal.
One same question Shiva Prasad is asking, when the currency is not supported by any government, why it should be invested?
That's what I have told you. It's a philosophical question. There are many people like Satoshi Nakamoto who has first coined this cryptocurrency thing and started this movement, and then he left out and nobody knows who is that or who is that group, but it has been taken forward by a group of people like the Linux software, which is open to all and it is accepted and people use it. Similarly, is in case of this cryptocurrency, this movement was started for the persons who are not interested in letting the regulators know anything about their transaction, their assets, their investment, or any kind of thing. They want for more transparency this particular thing, because it is in day broad light. Whatever transaction has taken place, it is registered on blockchain for everybody, every other person who has the key to see and verify.
I heard he is asking, when there are huge swings in the value, why an investor should invest?
That's what. When the share market goes up, people keep on investing in certain kind of shares all the time. Same thing. Because the speculation is the natural tendency of most of the humans.
One question which I had, Shailesh, sir, that if the currency is illegal, but the exchange is legal and exchange is officially allowed in India, if you sell and buy currency on that particular exchange, and you know that the proceeds of those particular currencies exchange gets remitted to your bank account, which is legal. In that case, how do we show
It will not be credited to bank. It will be credited to your ledger. You first understand that money doesn't come in that picture, national money. The only, suppose you are a seller and I am a buyer, both are trading on a cryptocurrency, the money is not changing hands. Only that cryptocurrency is changing hands in the ledger.
But on Wazirex exchange, when you buy a particular currency, at that time you trade in Indian rupees.
Yes, but we are trading, but that ledger is there, no? We are just investing in ledger. Money, cash money is given, then it is traded. If it is not, then only that account, we have various suspicious accounts recorded in many, many islands. From there also it could be done. That all sorts of things are there. But Wazirex, we definitely can do the trading.
Please go on.
Yes.
Sir, I had a very simple thing. If you could just explain, if anybody present here, say me, if I want to trade in a Bitcoin today, what exactly is the transaction that is required? You know, how does this happen? So at is real money involved or real money is not involved at all from start to end?
Physical money means the value is created in dollars. No, you have to invest in dollars kind of thing. Yeah, in India, dollar is to be invested, then RBI interface is required.
Okay.
As per the law.
Okay.
But as I told you,
if I have to trade in Bitcoin today, then what steps are required for me? I mean,
For that, first you have to log into the exchange.
Okay.
You have to sign in. Then you have to accept a space there. You have to request for the space.
Okay.
Then mining will be done by the miners for a particular amount of money what you are involved in. Suppose at this moment, two companies are involved for eBay and PayPal. If you are making payment to eBay from PayPal, naturally PayPal is American listed company. The money is going to be in Bitcoin form from PayPal to eBay. Both are accepting it. That has to be always there. Means here we are not investing it.
Okay.
We are doing transactions in it. We speculators are treating it as a making of money business.
Yeah.
That is what I want to make it clear. It is asset class. Even Wazirex will say it is asset. It is not currency. But cryptocurrency is known.
Yes,
Bitcoin is cryptocurrency.
Yeah, so to simplify, if I start mining a currency today and I have, say, 1,000 units of, say, a new currency called Pi. Now, if I'm logged on to that platform, I can look around for buyers and sellers who are accepting Pi as a currency for trades and then use that currency to buy or sell things which are available on such platform.
On that day, the rate has to be decided. That rate will decide everything. Means, suppose you buy something today and the currency's rate is gone down, the more Bitcoins will be required.
Okay. Like I got it. So there is no physical money involved in it.
No, not absolutely nothing. It is only the space which you get.
Yes.
Space in the public ledger, that is also on the internet.
Correct. So there was one question asked by Trisha Bhattacharya, and that is that I've heard a lot about non-fungible token. What is it? And the other one was about environmental impact, which I believe you've already talked about. So what is a non-fungible token is what she's asking.
Non-fungible token is a, as I told you, there are many different forms. I have just mentioned non-fungible token means it is.
ये बंद करनो रे तो कहीं करनो रे
सी बिग क्रिप्टोकरेंसीज प्रोटोकॉल टोकन्स यूटिलिटी टोकन सिक्योरिटी टोकन नेचुरल एसेट टोकन्स नॉन फंजेबल मींस वी जनरली थिंक दैट इट कैन नॉट बी कॉम्प्रोमाइज इनटू अदर यूज इफ पर्टिकुलर थिंग it is used. The Ethereum is a token. It is not a currency. If you are going to have some project on it, you can go on Ethereum and Ether is traded in it. That platform is available. Similarly, utility tokens are also, as mentioned. It is used for utility kind of purposes. That is how the non-fungible. If it is utility token, it will be only for utility functioning, not for any other transaction which we generally see with the Bitcoin, because it is considered as a digital currency, or what we call as cryptocurrency. But cryptography, the person who knows cryptography will be able to understand the difference between actual currency and cryptography.
Kailesh sir, I have a question.
Yes.
Since you said that this is not bankable currency and it's only an asset,
yeah.
So, but whenever I am in difficulty, I need some money. How do I get money out of these bitcoins or use?
You have to sell that at that trading.
But then where does that money get back to me in India?
That is
in
what exactly bank? Is the issue with us at this moment.
So that means there is no point in dealing in currency when I am sitting in India.
That's what I have written a series of articles in newspaper explaining it, that at presently in Indian system, for any common man with pockets full of cash, this is just the speculative things that jaise pitara khulega usme se kya niklega jab parliament act pass karegi us tarah ki baat hogi.
What is this machine exchange
bare mein abhi kuch nahi kar sakte keh sakte ki kya hoga, lekin jo bill parliament mein is winter session mein aana tha वो तो अभी आया नहीं है. सो इट विल टेक सम मोर टाइम. और जैसे मैंने आपको कहा कि अभी सिर्फ बहामास नाम की कंट्री ने डिजिटल कॉइन इश्यू किए हैं अपनी करेंसी के, इसके लिए वैसे अभी किसी ने नहीं किए हैं. बैंक ऑफ इंग्लैंड भी अभी काफी पीछे चल रहा है, वो उनका भी स्टडी चालू है. उनके भी गवर्नर ने कहा है कि वी विल स्टडी एंड ऑल दिस थिंग, बिकॉज उसके पूरा डिजिटल डिसरप्शन होने वाला है फाइनेंस फील्ड का. इसके लिए उसके बारे में सोचना बहुत ही आवश्यक रहेगा, क्योंकि मैंने जैसे कहा कि अगर आप अमेरिका में हैं, वहां तो अलग सिस्टम है पूरा सा. वहां पर पैसे भी आपने डिजिटल कॉइन में रजिस्टर भी करवा दिए है और ट्रेडिंग भी कंप्लीट कर ली. कुछ लोगों ने पैसे किए हैं, कुछ लोगों को पैसे भी नहीं मिले. मैं एक एग्जाम्पल आपको पढ़ के सुनाता हूँ, जिसमें वो आदमी उसी फील्ड में है क्रिप्टो करेंसी के, लेकिन क्या हुआ उसके साथ एक जरा सुनिएगा. डगलस साइडनबर्ग वॉज लिविंग इन द प्रोफेशनल लाइफ दैट अ लॉट ऑफ कॉलेज स्टूडेंट्स इमेजिन फॉर देमसेल्फ. ही वॉज अ फाइनेंशियल एनालिस्ट एट द लीड्स इक्विटी, अ हाई फ्लाइंग प्राइवेट इक्विटी फंड विथ ऑफिसेस ऑन पार्क एवेन्यू एंड 52nd स्ट्रीट इन मैनहट्टन एंड मोर देन हाफ ए बिलियन डॉलर्स अंडर मैनेजमेंट इन इट्स लेटेस्ट फंड. डगलस वॉज 29 ईयर ओल्ड विद द मास्टर्स इन फाइनेंस, बट हिज बेबी फेस एंड कर्ली रेड हेयर मेड हिम लुक मोर लाइक 19. His responsibilities and the leads included studying new investment and monitoring existing one in the fund's portfolio. When his friends and press began chattering about Bitcoin, Douglas decided it was time to get in. Like the diligent financial analyst he was, he spent a month studying how to buy and store Bitcoins before finally buying some. He also put a few thousand dollars of cash into an account he set up on Bitcoin exchange called Bitfloor. He then won a floor, $few thousand worth of Bitcoins on the online gambling sites, seals with clubs. He transferred his cash and Bitcoins from Bitfloor to the larger and then more reputable exchange, Mt. Gox. It was good timing. In just couple of days later on April 17, 2013, wheat floor shut down. Feeling confident and lucky that this point, Douglas bought another batch of Bitcoins, bringing his total to 67.3 Bitcoins along with the cash in his account. At 3 a.m. on 7 May, the day after his last cash infusion into his Mount Gox account, Douglas was having trouble sleeping and checked his email on the phone by his bed. He noticed a handful of emails from Mt. Gox with details of transactions that had just been made. He got a rush of adrenaline and ran to his computer. His username and password on Mount Gox had been changed. The cash in the account has been converted into Bitcoins, and together with the rest of the Bitcoins had been transferred out of his account. He had used two-factor authentication using not just the username and password, but also authentication code sent to his mobile phone for sales with the clubs, because he thought the site seemed a little dodgy. It has not occurred to him to do the same for Mt. Gox because it was so big and ostensibly secure. Douglas fired off emails to Mt. Gox. It was now 3.15 a.m. He wrote, "Hello, these two withdrawals requests were not done by me. In addition, the funds just deposited are stolen from me. Can I get my funds back? How did this happen?" 3 hours and 18 minutes later, he got a reply. "Hello, we sincerely regret this inconvenience. Our apologies for delay in response, and we are sorry to hear of your misfortune. We do really understand how difficult it would be to face this situation. As stated earlier, unfortunately, BTC transfers are not cancelable or reversible. We are extremely sorry to say that we do not have any option to credit the requested BTC. Fees that you paid was for the trading service that we offered. However, we are working on new development security measures which can help our users to overcome this kind of losses. I see the withdrawal has already been processed. Kindly refer to below link and process withdrawal cannot be traced or stopped. Make sure your password change password immediately and do not use the same username password on the services, and also make sure that the email account is secured and add software and YubiKey authentication to your account at the security center. Please file a police report and have them contact us, and we will gladly provide any documentation for investigation. We apologize for the inconvenience caused. For your information, I have updated your funds to zero, and in case if you need to change the withdrawal limits, you may contact us back for further assistance. Thanks, Mt. Gox team." See, this is the example.
Hi sir, I have one question.
Yes.
So nowadays, CoinSwitch Kuber is an Indian app which has advertising that you can trade in a Bitcoin or a cryptocurrency. So is it a safe app to trade with?
That's what I told you. I'm not competent to grade the apps at this moment. It is all risky business, as this example has illustrated. You can change from one exchange to another exchange and do the transactions, but risk lies with you. As I have told you, it is a publicly open ledger with no central authority to have anything registered, only the link, and your identity is only that password and that key.
But they are asking us a bank details to upload our money through the bank only.
Yes, sir. That is
and
how
they are even advertising on a Indian media.
Yeah, so, but recently the private banks have also disclosed that they are not going to support this cryptocurrency. I don't know at this moment, because this is a very emerging subject which is changing every day in and day out. Mm-hmm. 2 months back, as I told you, Elon Musk accepted the investments in Bitcoins, payments in Bitcoins, which he says now he won't accept.
Thank you, sir.
Whatever is illegal, said as illegal in India, how the advertisements and all those exchanges, etc., can function?
Because of the interpretation of the Supreme Court judgment.
So then if something is not legal, like advertising of liquor or cigarettes is not legal on the TV or any print media. So, but the use is there. So you are saying it is akin to that.
Yes. The thing is like this, the judgment says banks will not have anything to do with this particular cryptocurrency business because they are under the control of Reserve Bank and Reserve Bank doesn't recognize it. That means whatever is the responsibility, responsibility will be on the person who invests because financial stability is at stake, as I told you. The entire thing, Shaktikanta Das is also explicit about it. He has said, cryptocurrencies could have an adverse effect on financial stability, thus impacting economy. His comments came at a time when the value of the Bitcoin, when I was told you, that time had crossed $50,000. Then it reached 1 lakh. In past also, Indian government has expressed concern about digital currencies, claiming they are used for laundering charges, large quantity of money and terror funding. That's why major private banks like HDFC, HSBC, Citibank, ICICI, Axis Bank have already started questioning their account holders on cryptocurrency related transactions. Because during the KYC now or all these things, it will be there. Now that cryptocurrency and regulation official digital currency bill 2021 will have two intentions, create a facilitative framework for an official digital currency issued by RBI and B, to prohibit all private cryptocurrencies in India.
Varad Deshpande yacha vatela jau naka
sadhya tari.
Okay sir.
Okay, sir, thank you.
Sir, the cryptocurrency is illegal. In the last month, under when you know, media was talking to the finance minister Nirmala Sitharaman, but she could have told you know, straight away that it is illegal, you know, nothing to discuss about that. But she didn't tell that. She was telling that you know, we are not banned in India, but it is you know, we are trying to regulate it. You know. If it is illegal, she is the authority of India and she could have directly...
See, no, it is illegal means explicitly it is not made illegal. See, what happens, you know, in day-to-day life, the technology comes in and then the regulation follows. See, we had the Airwaves Act and it came through the case between Cricket Association of Bengal and Supreme Court. And Union of India case in Supreme Court, which declared that airwaves are private property. But before that, we had Kuwait war, and in which we had already started seeing the satellite television, which was not so. But that it was already there, no? So it was not illegal as well as legal, but it was there. Same condition is there at this moment about the cryptocurrency. Nobody explicitly can say it is illegal, but it is illegal.
Actually, ये topic इतना बड़ा है ना कि जितना भी इस पे बात करो ना कम है और questions कभी कम नहीं होने वाले. लेकिन time हमको permission नहीं देता है. मैं हेमंत जी को बोलता हूँ कि sir please vote of thanks और announcement upcoming projects के बारे में बताएंगे please.
राजजी thank you. I want to thank our guest speaker today, Shailesh Malode. It so happened that I had approached Mr. Vinayak Govilkar, our well-known chartered accountant in our city, to ask him that I want to cover this particular topic and then whether there is any suitable person who we can invite and then who can shed more light on this particular subject, which is so very complex, so very novel, so very new, and then there is not much clarity on that. And he said that if you want to have convincing and then the most comprehensive knowledge on this particular subject, the only person I can suggest is Shailesh Malode. So along with Sir Shailesh, sir, I also want to thank Mr. Vinayak Govilkar explicitly for suggesting your name, and then we are thankful to both of you.
Yes, sir. Dr. Govilkar is my guru in finance.
I also want to thank our President Mugdha, both the secretaries for their wholehearted support. Any new topic which I, as a program committee chairman, when I come out with any new topic, both all the three people, that is president and two secretaries, are very supportive, and then they extend all the support which is possible. I also want to thank Akash Sonar for his graphic designing. You will notice that the graphic designing, he came out with a flyer which is so very innovative, and then
very innovative.
And then I also want to thank him for that, for coming out with this particular super flyer. I want to thank both my month leaders, our Kirti Tak madam, and then I also want to thank Kirti Tak madam and Raj Talreja for giving me the mic.
Exactly, what is meant by two secretaries? I'm not getting it. Two secretaries.
Yeah, our club has two secretaries. One is the admin and one is the projects. So that's why I said that I want to thank both the secretaries. Raj Talreja and Kirti Tak madam have been our month leaders for this particular May month, and then they have put in tremendous amount of
You got muted, Hemant sir. Yeah.
Is it okay now?
Yeah,
audible.
Yeah. So thank you, Kirti. Thank you, Raj. Thank you, everyone who has contributed in this particular project very, very wholeheartedly. My task, I'm filling in for our secretary, Praful Badiaji, whose normal secretarial duties is to propose a vote of thanks and also make announcements for the upcoming programs. On 22nd May, that is the Saturday, we are coming out with a very, very subject which in current pandemic is very dear to all of us. Dr. Gajanan Sapkar, who is a leading scientist with National Institute of Virology, and who is also credited with co-development of Covaxin, is going to be with us on our virtual platform. So I would request all of you to do join in, and then know from the, as they say, from the horse's mouth, what is the mystery regarding Covaxin, and then whether it is really going to be helpful or not. On 25th May, that is the Tuesday, we are going to be having with us Dr. Rajendra Barve. He is the leading eminent internationally known psychiatrist, and he will speak on the current need of the hour, which is building resilience in times of pandemic. Everyone sitting at home and then not being able to mix with the public around is getting into some sort of mood which is not very happy. So that is what he is going to tell us, that how to keep your morale up, and then how to build your resilience. On 27, 28, 29, we will be coming out with E. Raila. So E. Raila is a signature project of Rotary Club of Nasik, and I would request Mugdha Lele to speak a few words on this particular project specifically.
Thank you, Hemant sir. Raila is a project that we conduct for tribal students, and we generally conduct it for over 100 tribal students on or spread over 3 days. Considering the pandemic, it has not been possible this year. So we are hosting it on a virtual platform, and we have split it into morning session and evening sessions. And we will start on 28th evening, and we will have a few hour sessions in the morning, few hour sessions in the evening. Because we figured that for any person to sit continuously at a stretch virtually is a little difficult. The entire Rotaract team is taking a huge amount of efforts for this. Rotarian Shilpa Parakh is the Rotaract director, as well as all the Rotaractors and the committees from the district. We are planning to host it for Zone 5 and 6. One, Raila has already been conducted. This will be the second one. And I would request everybody to spread word about it so that people can join and benefit from the sessions organized. Thank you so much.
The last thing which I want to announce is every year when the new Rotary board is voted in and the Rotary year starts from 1st July, our RID 3030, this year we will be conducting the training session for all the incoming board members. And then I'm very happy to announce that our club secretary, the secretary elect, Mangesh Apshankar, President Mugdha Lele, and Ajay Narkesri, who is the club trainer, they are the ones who will be going to be the training people for the trainers. They are going to be the training for, you know, the RID 3030 trainers. So congratulations, the trio of RCN, and then Mugdha, over to you for your concluding remarks and then to adjourn the meeting.
Thank you so much, Eamon sir. Thank you for a wonderful, wonderful session, Marade sir. And there were a lot of requests from the audience, which you promptly responded to for converting to English and Hindi, because I think people had joined from all over, such as the popularity of the topic and your popularity as a speaker, I know. So we are Facebook Live already, and I will share the link and the recording to you. And the recording will obviously be there on Facebook Live. Thank you for it. It was a wonderful session, and it brought much cheer to the otherwise gloomy atmosphere which is happening right now. I sincerely thank each and every Rotarian who's attending from outside of our club, be it outside or some outside our district too. I'm very, very happy to have you over virtually, and I hope that we can meet physically very soon at the first opportunity. We would definitely like to share more information about our programs, and I would therefore take this chance to invite all of you for our next two sessions as well. We will definitely share information with you, and we would request you to do the same so that we can all benefit from each other's activities. So on that note, thank you very much once again, and I declare the meeting adjourned, and the timing is not over at all. So whoever wants to stay back and chat is most welcome to do so. So everybody can unmute themselves, and if you want to have a free open talk, please, everybody can go ahead and do it. So thank you so much, Marade sir.
Thank you. It was a pleasure interacting with you all, and lovely. Definitely we'll meet sometime as early as possible as this pandemic gets over.
Yes, sir. Vinayak Govilkar sir is my guru as well, and I think you speak for most of Nasik professionals when you say that. He's an iconic person, and he has come to our club several times. Yeah. So when Govilkar sir tells us that you're an authority, we respond with an alacrity. You know, that is very natural, I think, for anybody in Nasik. And I think it was fully justified. Thank you so much. It was
Thank you. It was my pleasure.
We added our email ID and mobile number in the chat. Can we get a link of the recording? Myself, yes. Nagjyoti Bolla Prada from RC Vishrambagh, Sangli, Maharashtra.
Okay.
And thank you so much for wonderful session and unique presentation. At the same time, this is a unique thing we come to know today, that there, in one club, there may be a two secretaries, like project as well as general secretary, and very good idea. Because in such situation, we can more concentrate on the projects if project secretary is appointed.
Yeah.
And work will be distributed equally. Thanks a lot for that wonderful idea.
Yeah.
And implement.
Thank you, ma'am. I think this was need-based more than anything else, because our club is 76 year old. It's now in its 76th year, and we are around 150 people, and we do humongous amount of projects. This year we've done projects worth 47.5 lakh through CSR funding alone.
Congratulations.
Yes, thank you, ma'am.
And we need guidance of yours also. That's why I have added everything. Let us be in touch. And in environment, what you people are going to do? I am a M.Tech environment engineer and really want to know about the environment with the rotary aspects.
Yes.
We are dealing with the sugar and distillery industry. And till time worked with the industry only, waste management. Now, socially, how we can work that idea I can have from your club also. Thank you so much.
Definitely. Rotarian Hemant Marathe, who was just conducting and just giving the vote of thanks, he's going to be the environment chairperson for the next year. So I'm sure he'll be in touch with you and he'll be more than happy. And I'm sure that we can collaborate in the future for sure. So,
shall I add once again or it is okay? Already I have given my email ID and contact. I will add once again.
Yeah, I think you do that because if it's gone, there were a lot of questions. So I think it's been just post it once again. I'll jot it down. Hemant sir, please, you would also jot it down.
I will also jot it down.
Mudha madam.
Yes.
Can you give some details about your e-Raila?
Yes, sir. Like I said, it's being organized for zone 5 and 6. We are finalizing the sessions, but in the morning sessions, we will have sessions on yoga and on a little bit on some physical activities and fitness and, general well-being. And the afternoon sessions are going to be more on focused on career choices, on things like public speaking or interviewing skills and things like that. But as soon as the program is finalized, sir, I'll send you a link with all the details when the brochure comes up, which will be anytime soon.
Can our group zone from, we're from 7 zone, na?
Sir, I think it should be okay, not an issue.
Because,
I'll send you the link, sir. Not a problem.
Yeah. Madam, it was a nice session. Thanks for inviting and I will be leaving.
Thank you, sir. It was only befitting after the session that you conducted for us last week. It was wonderful.
Thank you, Birthday, sir, for inviting me.
I wanted to add certain points, but I didn't want to break the speaker's chain. So,
yes.
No problem. And today I can see past president Jiggles from Rotary Club Accra Tesno, who's still sitting over here.
Okay.
He's from Ghana.
Oh, okay. Wow. Yes, Jiggles is there. Yes. He had asked, yeah.
Hello. The sort of interest this particular topic has generated is really evident that for most of the time which we were having the session, we had the capacity audience of 100 on our, Zoom ID.
Even last week, I got many messages later that we could not enter because of this.
Yeah. I know. Hello, Kevadaram.